Hi kids, so today in our lesson we will learn how bad and awful inbreeding and incest can be for not only for your health but also for your face. Because I have top 5 of the ugliest kings on our planet in history. So yeah, I think it's really interesting and I don't want to look like a skinny little bitch who will talk how ugly their faces were, but actually I want to tell you that incest is the biggest mistake of royal families and how dangerous it can be for people. And I want to tell you and describe you how awful and painful their lives of those kings. So yeah, and don't forget to subscribe on my channel and maybe write in the comments our first victim and the biggest victim of inbreeding. It will be really interesting, but actually I think I know who will you choose. But okay, let's start from our first victim. Actually it's she, and she wasn't a king but she was a princess, and her name is Ruth Luka and thousands of another names, but even Google Translator doesn't have a language of Hawaii Islands. She served as a governor of the island of Hawaii. At those times, islands were under the pressure and influence of England, of English language, of Victorian style. They were built a lot of Victorian mansions. There were really popular Victorian dresses, and Ruth was actually, yeah, she was unbelievably ugly, but actually she was really wise and very eccentric woman. So she knew English language, but she always needed help of the translator. And why she was so ugly? Actually, there were rumors that her mother married on her father. So as you can see, she was unbelievable huge, over 200 kilograms, and she was unbelievable high, over like almost 2 meters. And people described her voice as a distant rumble of thunder. So it's really, I think it was really scared to work with such a woman. And as you can see, her nose was ruined because of bad operation, but actually there were also rumors that it was her second husband, because they had a lot of fights. So yeah, maybe Ruth wasn't really like beautiful, but actually she was really wise. And at those times where women like didn't have any voices, and she was really successful businesswoman. So, and let's continue with our second victim, Carl II, King of Spain. And it's unbelievable how disproportional and ugly can be human face. Actually, in Ukraine, here we have his real portrait in the art gallery, and every time when I'm walking there, I'm like, la la la, beautiful pictures, beautiful art, and like going to his portrait, I'm like, oh my god, oh my god. Every single time I was there, like 10 times, and every time it's just hard to look at his portrait. So okay, let's start our list of his problems. He didn't speak till he was 4. He didn't walk till 8. He spoke and ate with difficulty because he had really huge and disproportional tongue. He had huge Habsburg typical lip, and his tongue was too big. His heart was too small. His head was full of water. So his parents, of course, were uncle and niece. So it's really interesting that simple and normal people in 5 generations have 35 different ancestors, but Carl had only 10, and 8 of them were children's and grandchildren's of Anne the Mad, who's also mother, and she had schizophrenia. Sure, so it was unbelievable, awful, awful mistake and awful family. Actually, it's well known that Habsburg royal family was the ugliest family between all royal families. So his mother thought that he was just ill, so he decided to practice an exorcism on him really, really often. So actually he died at the age of 39. It's really unbelievable big number for human with such problems. And actually during the time when Carl II was king of Spain, Spain was in unbelievable bad situation, country was really poor. So, and our third victim is Leopold I, also from Habsburg's family. So I don't want to talk nothing, just look at this picture. I think it was a rumor that he even couldn't walk when it was rain because his mouth was full of water because it was like too big and disproportional. So, and actually in different art galleries you can see a lot of kings, and if you will see like someone with can know that it's 100% that it's someone from Habsburg family. So, and almost our last victim is Ferdinand I of Austria. So, of course, like all our kings, he was incapable of ruling his country because he had really big mental problems. So, and typical romantic situation, his parents were double sister and cousin. Suffered from hydrocephalus. Yes, his head was unbelievable big. Also, he knew 5 languages, he was crazy about science, he really loved reading. During one day he could have 20 seizures. It was really awful for him and painful, and when he tried to consummate his marriage, he had 5 seizures. So actually he died at the age of 82. So, and our last, of course, but not least king is Tutankhamun, and I think everyone knows about him because he is like the popular member of Egypt family, royal family. But why? Actually, just really simple. He was really young. He didn't have any big achievements. He's popular only because his tomb wasn't disturbed by different people, and our archaeologists and scientists find his tomb not touched and perfectly saved with all the treasures and with all the information about his family. So also he had a wife, his half-sister Anksunamon, and they had 2 children, and of course they didn't survive because one was born already dead and another was born with awful and big problems with health. Poor kid was born with spina bifida, scoliosis and Sprengel's deformity, and actually he was really tall, almost 2 meters. So, and let's start our list of incest problems of Tutankhamun. So he had a large frown, incisions and overbite charismatic of the Thutmosis royal line to which he belonged. Also he had a slightly left palate and possibly a mild case of scoliosis. Also he was unable to move his head, so he just moved like that. Yeah. Also his left foot was deformed. He had a female body. His father Akhenaton had the same strange body type. Yeah, you can see that they had really a small waist, big boobs and really big hips. So actually we don't know how Tutankhamun died. There are a lot of rumors, but actually that's all. Yeah, write down our first victim of incest and inbreeding, and I hope it was really interesting for you, and goodbye till the next video.